Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel Open Green Energy. In this video, I will show you how I have made this solar lamp by using a very few electronics components. This lamp is designed to provide basic lighting to the rural people. The lamp can be charged by the inbuilt solar panel, or you can plug in an external solar panel for faster charging. Guys, if you are new to my channel, then don't forget to subscribe it. Please hit the bell icon so that you will get notified whenever I upload a new video. So without any further delay, let's move to make the project. The solar lamp is a standalone solar photovoltaic system. It contains four basic components. First, the solar panel, controller, battery, and LED. The solar panel converts solar energy into electrical energy. The controller have two functions: to charge the battery during the daytime and drive the LED during the night. The battery stores the energy generated by the solar panel. And the last component is LED, which produce the desired output light. The heart of the solar lamp is the controller. Here I am using QX5252F as the controller. First, I made the circuit on a breadboard. Then I checked the performance by using my DSO. I have designed my final PCB on Autodesk Fusion 360. Here I am going to show you the assembling of my earlier version. The process of assembling of new version and the earlier version is very similar. In the new version, you have to only add two additional components, that is the diode and the capacitor. Now let's move to assemble the PCB. It is always good practice to solder the component according to their height. So I solder the lesser height component first. In this solar lamp PCB, inductor is the lesser height component. So I soldered the inductor first, then I trimmed the extra leg by using a nipper. Now I am going to solder the two JST connectors. One is for solar panel connection and the next one is for battery terminal connection. During the soldering, confirm that the polarity of the connectors is correct. The next component that I am going to solder is QX5252F. You can refer the picture for pinout. Now solder the 8mm straw hat LED on the back side of the PCB. The longer leg of the LED indicates the positive terminal. Now the PCB is ready for connecting the solar panel and battery. Here I am using a 2V solar panel. Before soldering the terminal wires to the solar panel, apply small amount of flux. Similarly, I have soldered the JST connector's terminal wire to the battery contacts. Then I have soldered two terminal wires to the rocker switch. To insulate the soldering joints, I have applied heat sink tube. Then I have prepared the 5.5 mm female DC jack to connect an external solar panel. I have soldered a Schottky diode to the positive terminal of the DC jack to avoid the reverse current flow. Now our PCB along with all the other components are ready for assembling into the enclosure. The nice 3D printed enclosure for this lamp is designed by my friend Varun in Autodesk Fusion 360. The enclosure have two parts, the main body part and the front reflector part. I have printed the main body with green color PLA and the reflector part with white color PLA. Now I am going to apply a coat of bright chrome spray paint on the front reflector part. Leave it 4 to 5 hours to dry it completely. Now you can install the components along with PCB by using hot glue. Now I am going to solder the rocker switch terminal wires to the PCB board. At last you have to solder the two terminal wires from the DC jack to the PCB board. Connect the solar panel and battery JST connector to the PCB board. For this project you will need a AA nickel metal hydride rechargeable battery. Here I am using a AnyLoop battery. To test the lamp, turn on the rocker switch, then cover the solar panel with your palm. You can see the LED will glow. This is a snap and fit enclosure, so there will be no requirement of additional mounting screw. You can plug in an external 4 to 5 volt solar panel for faster charging. Before the first use of the solar lamp, I will recommend to charge the battery fully. The brightness of the lamp is sufficient for reading a book at the night or for any general purpose use. All the important information and further update on this project will be available on my Instructable page. Guys, I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please subscribe my YouTube channel by hitting the subscribe button and don't forget to hit the bell icon. Thank you.